is a mentorship program. We do not discriminate by age, but we get a lot of young people very interested to make something of their talents. Right now, we have spoken word poets, we have writers, we have songwriters, we have, and also a few comedians. And coming up next are a few young people who only joined us recently, very, very talented writers and performers and spoken word poets. And we are very, very proud to be able to host them and give them a voice so that they can tell us their experiences of living in Penang and how all these changes and all this heritage affects them personally. So coming up next to tell us stories of their personal as well as public lives, please welcome the young participants from Say It Like You Mean It, Claudia, Anwar and Kasvini. We are starting with Miss Claudia Angelique. Give her a big hand.
Hello everyone, I'm Claudia Angelique. I'm singer-songwriter and poet here at Say It Like You Mean It. Today I will be performing two of my original poems for you. This first piece is called The Man. How does it feel to barely sleep because you cannot cry? How does it feel to barely sleep and to stay up all night and try? How does it feel when all the tears you long for cannot flow? How does it feel to watch your loved ones weep, the fears you could not keep, the lie you say, it's all okay, but you watch your children fade away? How does it feel when your son now says, I want to be anything unlike you? How does it feel to know that I'm pushed to write this about you? Thank you. That was The Man. Now for my second and final piece. This one's for Honey. We ran away together, killing ourselves to match pace. With gritted teeth and fists, I said, I love you. And you kissed my face. But now I sit down right beside you. I can barely feel you near. I close my eyes and wish you could find a way to care. But then the magic happens, and the spaces disappear. Once again, I'm in your arms, safe, beyond all harm. With my eyes shut, I watched it burn. The fiery pieces of our hearts shine bright, melt into one. Soon my eyes must open, I know. And I know I'll regretfully see that I'm in love with your illusions. You're already as far away as can be. Thank you very much.
Hi everyone. My name is Anwar, and I'll be performing two pieces for you today. The first one is called Kotak Otak. It's about wanting to grow, even though you know that you have weaknesses about yourself. And some both of these pieces are in Malay, just so you know. Rangkap demi rangkap, aku rasa, aku tangkap, aku guna, aku ungkap, aku tanya, aku jawab ringkas kata, aku cekap. Troka dunia tak bermazhab, tiada peta, jadi kerap aku jumpa orang sentap. Tapi prosa datang dengan tanggungjawab. Salah guna kelak nanti kan diazab. Kurang faham bahasa, minta masuk maktab. Aku cuma suarakan peringatan kat diri sendiri yang lembab. Oops, aku baru kutuk diri aku sendiri. Dunia rap tak terima, ku bawa haluan kiri. Tak ada tongkat, aku tetap cuba berdiri. Kemudian aku jalan, lepas tu ku berlari. Tapi sekarang masa untuk merangkak. Setiap pergerakan tangan kaki aku orak. Terjadi corak, walaupun ia porak. Tetap ada otak yang enggan dimasukkan kotak. Jadi sorak-sorak, kami enggan masuk kotak. Sorak-sorak, kami enggan masuk kotak. Sorak-sorak, kami enggan masuk kotak. Sorak-sorak, sorak-sorak. Thank you very much. Second piece is called Sedikit Kelakar. This is a piece from the Apong zine that you can find at the back of the establishment here. All right, so it's called Sedikit Kelakar. It's about my observations of Malaysian politicians that we can see in the Malaysian political scene and how they're a bit funny to me. Cuba kau fikir, daripada membazir waktu berpasir hingga ruang bawah terbanjir, siapakah Anasir sebenar menyabotir masa depan anak-anak kita yang kecil? Adakah benar apa yang keluar daripada mulut-mulut orang perasan besar? Apa yang disiar di dalam akhbar, entahlah. Bagi aku ada sedikit kelakar. Cuba jadi popular dengan kenyataan-kenyataan kurang pintar. Semua bersandar pohon tak berakar, akal tebal selumbar. Seronok bercelupar, hingar bingar. Banyak sungguh pendekar, tapi hujah dilontar berdasar fakta sifar. Guna bahasa pengantar, talam sembilan muka, ibarat seekor pegar jaga nasi kandar. Takut kita tak sedari, para pemikir yang patut kita segani, kian dipinggir, kian tak didengari, kian dijelir. Cahaya nipis dipelopori oleh mereka yang belum merdeka jiwa dan raga, yang hanya diguna sebagai boneka oleh para pemuka, para penderhaka, para ahli neraka. Bersuit zennya, kereta Jaguar, isteri tiga, perempuan simpanan lima, impian makhluk bertuhankan dunia. Semoga kita semua dipelihara Maha Esa. Thank you.
Sebatang kara hidup saya untuk 20 lebih tahun. Pokok kaktus setia menunggu sahara menyelami El Nino dan anjakan zaman. Menunggu glasier besar-besaran menelan butir-butir pasir-pasir demi membawa cintaku. Pokok kaktus masih menunggu bagai tugu. Aku teo, kau kopi. Aku teo, kau susu pekat. Bersama kita harum. Aku teo, kau susu pekat. Kehadiranmu, oh, sangat jelas. Setiap inci tubuh ini dimanisi gulamu. Pahitlah hidupku tanpa karenahmu. Tapi sayang, badan ini dibuat secara organik, dalam kata lain, diabetik. Jadi sayang, segala manik mu dengan permata dan mutiara memberikan kanser barah membara, barah kita, barah membara, barah kita, barah kita ini membakar tanpa bahan api, tanpa kayu, tanpa kertas, tanpa surat cinta, mahupun hadiah. Barah kita. cinta ini tiada sentuhan mahupun cemburuan. Tiada sentuhan berdasarkan tulisan pada fikiran dan minda. Barah kita ini membakar segala oksigen, 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 oksigen. Kau telah membakar segala oksigen and leaving me in deep, deep, deep suffocation.
Ladies and gentlemen, the young performers from Say It Like You Mean It, please put your hands together for Claudia Anwar Kasvini. We're very, very proud of them. Some of them have just joined us a few months ago. Some of them have been with us for a while. A lot of their work, or some of their work, is collected in our Apong anthology. So if you want to read up on them a little bit, you can check it out at the back with the Gerak Budaya bookstore. It's orange, it says Apong, and it says crispy poetry. It's easy to find, no problem. Okay. And for those of you who may be interested, you're thinking right now, like, well, I have some talent as well. Maybe I could do something. So if you feel like you have something that you want to say, a skill or a talent that you want to show to the world, you can find us online now because we have a website. We're legit, yo. We got a website. You can find us on sayitmeanitpenang.com or you can find one of us at this table and we'll give you the URL if you can't remember it. You can also log on your mobile, sign up for our newsletter and join us for our shows next year in China House. So what we do is we take people with talent and interests, we give them opportunities and skills, and then we do shows at China House so you can come and perform. We do shows at GTLF, and hopefully next year we'll be doing shows in other places as well. But, you know, we'll wait for the announcement on our website. Coming up next, so we've heard English poetry, Malay poetry, there's a bit of Tamil in there as well. Anybody knows what's missing? Chinese! Cannot. So we got a solution for that, okay? Our next performers are very, very, two young, very young people. Very attractive as well. Thank you. They call themselves the Sijin Poets. Am I pronouncing that right? Sijin. Their project is very interesting because they have taken Hokkien poetry and then translated it into English, taken English poetry and translated it into Hokkien. So why do this work? The reason being is because Hokkien poetry is so... Who's read Hokkien poetry recently? Hands up. That one guy, right? Hokkien poetry is so rare. When have you seen Hokkien poetry? So the whole point of this is to bring back this culture of writing and reading Hokkien poetry. And so please give them a big hand, Mr. Kihau and Ms. Yasmin Badmanathan.
Hello.
Oh, hi.
How come they don't respond? Hi. Yeah, hi.
Hi. Okay, yeah. So we are called the Sijin Poets, Kihau Yasmin. And yeah, it's an experimental poetry project that has taken 2 years of our fucking life.
Yeah.
You know, and what we did was Kihau has written 13 original poems in...
Correct, in Penang Hokkien. Hokkien, not just Hokkien, it's in Penang Hokkien.
Yeah. And then I was supposed to translate it into English. And then we realized, oh shit, how do you translate worldviews? How do you translate things in so intrinsic in a culture into English? So we were like, okay, you know what? 1 year in and we were like, screw this. We are going to do reinterpretation. So he sat down and explained his, you know, Hokkien poetry. I don't understand Hokkien. explain then, like, okay, so this is what it means, so this is how I interpret it in English, according to my worldview. And then, even though he is so, you know, good in English and...
Yeah, I speak English, but the thing is, I am from a Chinese background. I am Chinese educated, so there are things that I do not understand in an English poem. So she has to explain all that to me as well.
Yeah, so 2 years. Our book was supposed to be launched at the festival. It's today. Still in... with the designers being laid out.
Yeah. But it's coming out, okay?
It's so coming out, it's coming out. Next year, we'll be there. Yeah. So, yeah, so we're going to read some poems from that. So it'll go English, Hokkien, Hokkien, English, Hokkien, something like that. Yeah. Okay, so this first poem is called Away. And since we are during the Penang Goes Orange campaign, so, you know, we have to talk about violence against women. So this is a poem that I wrote way before Penang Goes Orange, but, you know, here it goes. He walked further and further away from where she stood forlorn, reeling from his rebuke. A tear, a single tear solitary in his defiance, rolled down her left cheekbone, chiseled just like her mother's. The sun glazed through the wetness of her eyes, breaking the light into a million sparkles, turning him into nothing more than a speck in a profusion of light. Years down the road, she'll recall this very moment as the time she felt a weight lift off of her. She would picture the shackles falling off her ankles, the one that kept her enslaved to his moods, swinging forever the pendulum. As he walked further and further away from where she stood, rejoicing in the solitude of her personhood. Thank you.
Okay, I'm nervous now because I am writing it from a very different angle, and it's in Hokkien, and I'm not a woman. Okay, and in Hokkien, the title is Li Kui Kia Joey Kiaki Zhao Joey Zhao Ki Chun Lu Jilang Godwan Yaho Chiu Chin Yaho Ming Guan Ye Bin Sik Ming Tia Ye Sai Lang Bab Yu Bo Pua How How Be Chisia Titi, Titua, Lao, Lao Jip Sania. But you bo poa, Gia Gui Lui Chui Pei, Zhao Gui Lui Chiu Pang. Jitao, Tong Gui Bakju Pinye Zui Liap, Jisiam Jisi, Jia Ban Diao Sik Swan, Qua Be Dio, Ye Bin Hing, Qua Be Dio, Ye Sin King. Gai Gui Ni, Bo Dian Dio Lu, Esion Ki, Hi Jit Hi Si, So Yi Ging, Bo Tua Bo Kiam. Chuan Kui, Utan Tao Bang, King Tao, Utan Kin Sang, Bodan Dio Lu, Egamka, Kagu So Tao, So Wan Juan, Gai Guan, Liao Duan, Min Guzai, Guan Ye Bin Sik, Min Guzai, Tia Ye Sai Lang, Zhao, Joey Zhao Ki, Gia, Joey Gia Ki, Godwa, Yu An Zwa, Chiu Chin, Yu An Zwa, Gia, Gaki Gia Loki, Zhao, Gaki Zhao Chiki. Thank you. And the second point is actually is originally written by myself. It's my romantic relationship. But it didn't work well, so we ended it. Aww. Yeah, bigger, louder, yeah. Okay, so this is originally written in Hokkien, so it would sound, I would say, more natural to be heard in Hokkien as well. It's called Wa de itao kwan de Lucy. Wa de itao kwan de Lucy. Ti. 是水冷的，风是轮不的。全世界敢若有音乐声，路我伫路底，看街路顶的人，一车一景，路的声音是安尼孤单，是安尼沉重。我唔敢出声，我唔敢惊话。我第一道惊话路时，有树叶为我出声，心情安尼沉重，但是。 免驚孤單，佮有我的聲音。我陪路看街路的人，的車，的景。陪路我伫路底，全世界有人講話音樂聲，風關在輪渦，天關在水冷，人第一道看到人時。Thank you.
So beautiful. Did I understand a word, but still so beautiful. Okay, so this is my interpretation of this. It's called You. The first time I saw you, the sky a clear turquoise, the wind a gentle caress, the whole world a private symphony in perfect harmony with you. Standing on that balcony, watching the world pass by, your shadow casting a hole on the street. Shaped just like you, a hole that I wanted so badly to dive in and give comfort. I kept my distance, afraid to make a move, lest I disturb the equilibrium and break the spell, the moving picture, the one with you as the star that has had me so enthralled. As you stood on the balcony, the wind a gentle caress, the sky a clear turquoise, it was the first time that I saw you.
Okay, how come this one louder? Because they understand better, is it?
Faham lah.
Okay, so the third one is also written by me in Hokkien and interpreted conceptually by Yasmin later. So this is called Po Te Ji Nya. Ujoku Boko Kwa, Je Kim Uin Seke Ti, Bui Jit Me Jeng, Tui Hong Ki Bu E Chen Hiu, Ji Tao, Kana Ng Kam Li Kui, Hun Bui Kan Tuai Lam Hun, Hai Eng Sia, Bo Hui, Bo Kin, Ulang Tia Gui, Je Lo Ding Di Chiu Gua. Ujoku Boko Kwa, Hi Bai Lao Diam Chu, Go Zha Si Ye Kwan Yo, Ka Me Ki, Ding Bang Bo Chen Hun E Gui Ke, Bo Diao Di, 是这饼墙家庭的色彩，说好这罗龙镜，一暝暗拍出名声。有多久无高看，这行杯出下，甲细汉时行过的经验，哈密树走作安尼大。
Okay, so yeah, we carefully selected the poems for this time because we've been with Say It Like You Mean It performing for 2 years now. And, you know, our book only has like a total of 52 poems. So, you know, you can only like, you know, recycle how many times, right?
But it's actually 26 lah, 26 pairs lah.
Yeah lah, yeah. Huh? Right, 26 pairs. Okay, so, right. Okay, yeah, so, yeah, I think I'll just... Going back, like how, you know, we tried translating and it could not happen. So we were like totally lost in translation. So we were like, how do we find ourselves in translation? And that's why our book is called Found in Translation. It should be out soon, hopefully. And it's all illustrated. Each poems are illustrated. He has worked with one illustrator. I worked with a different one, stylist. You know, once you can get it, you can go color la, whatever la can. Okay, so this is his poem. It's called A Wisp of the Past. The Georgetown of my youth is a place long forgotten. Sunset skies, golden like salted egg yolks, refusing to melt into the night despite the seductive dance of the leaves. The fiery sun remains unpersuaded, surrounded by the songs of the waves. The clouds floated, trailing wisps of bluish enigma. On the snaking streets of the Georgetown of yore, the lampposts whisper their secret songs of love and worship to the ancient gods of merchants and goldsmiths, lords and shophouses, big and small. But how long has anyone paused to hear the pulse of Georgetown? When I now walk the narrow streets of my home, something is amiss. Gone is the sleepy facade of the ancient shophouses, their pot-bellied gods long chased away by the sinewy spirits of modernism. Gone are the mold-encrusted walls and crumbling plasters, only to be replaced by sparkly monuments to Georgetown's heritage. Almost overnight, my Georgetown has transformed. Today, when I walk her streets, I see ghosts of what she once was. The lover of my youth. Thank you.
Thank you.
Hey, like that only, never say thank you all. ladies and gentlemen, Seijin Poets. Please look out for their book. It's going to be awesome. Hopefully by the next Georgetown Literary Festival. Yeah. Speaking of, we would really like to thank the Georgetown Literary Festival for giving us the opportunity to host all these wonderful poets who would otherwise not have a space to perform or to share their pieces. So please, a big thank you, Georgetown Literary Festival. Thank you, thank you. And also to Gerak Budaya for you know, putting up the booths and selling out books and, like, you know, hawking it to everybody who's passing by. Thank you, Gerak Budaya. Speaking of now, like, I'd say it like you mean it. We've been doing this for 3 years now. We have 8 shows at China House every year from January to August. Next year, we'll be back again for the 4th year with 8 new shows. If you're in Penang or you're visiting Penang and you want to check out what's going on at China House with Say Like You Mean It, you can always find our schedule on sayitmeanitpenang.com. We'll be putting up the schedule for 2016 pretty soon. We are very, very proud of all the performers that come through our door who are so dedicated to not just learning their craft and mastering it, but making sure stories about their home, about their community, get out there. Not just the sanitized versions, but the real versions that affect people, right? So the next performer that I'm calling actually performed for the first time a few years ago at the Say It Like You Mean It open mic at the Georgetown Literary Festival in 2011. I think she'll correct me later. But her first performance was that. Yesterday, she performed for the Georgetown Literary Festival, a show called Pontiana. It was like, boom! Right? Amazing! Right? I was going there like, whoa! She's also performing again, I think, next weekend in Langkawi. Maybe she'll tell you more about it later. But here, to perform her pieces and also to tell you about her new book, please put your hands together for Melissa Rani.
Hello, Georgetown. Hello, everybody. Hi. Thank you so much, Danny. There is something magical about this stage. I swear, like, this is exactly the same spot that I stood and did my first spoken word poem about 3.5 years ago or so. And then now I'm here with a book, and it's crazy. It's amazing. But it all started here. So I'm going to cut right through it because I got 7 minutes, right? Okay. Right. So, any KL people in the house? KL people, KL. Hey. Okay. Cool. So, I'm gonna do a story about a city. Yeah. That's how I'm gonna introduce it. This is called "To the Matcha That Got Away." I saw you at the corner of Tengku Kelana, underneath the neon billboard of Along advertisements. Your skin was the color of my rusty heritage, a brown so distinct and iconic, like Klang River. You polluted my heart with catcalls and deep stares that made me want to check my horoscope and wonder what was yours. If you were Scorpio, I would rearrange the stars till you were compatible with Virgo. So when our shadows met for the first time, I noticed your smile. Synonymous to pleasant or promiscuous, I could not tell if it was one or the other. I decided it was both, so I curved my lips like bending the sides of calendar pages, waiting for a good date to meet your eyes. When it arrived, I was dazzled by the reflective sunglasses you wore at night. Confusion was your standard uniform, dressed in a black shirt that was too branded for H&M because you liked the material airy, soft, breathable, 100% cotton, made in Malaysia, boyfriend material you are not. The brightest Kutuvelika oil lamp in the box. Form 5 was the beginning of your prolific playboy career. Ambitious flings with 4 college degrees, one after the other, but at 31, I was sure you had finally settled on making educated stabs in a career of false prospects. Like the Ane, with developed instincts and greater consciousness, like the Ane who knew my order even before I sat down, choosing you was like ordering without a menu. Although the loopholes in your logic was like the center of every vade my diet regrets, I giggled at every Tamil movie reference I did not understand, because you know I like the bad boy type, the kind that holds a 9-year grudge from a 2-month relationship. Shattering your heart against the great wall of ex-girlfriends, you were never gonna dance again, but Careless Whisper was still your theme song till you found out George Michael was gay. Day, you won't get infected la. I tried to reason, but you wouldn't listen, adjusting your glasses till you could see me straight. Your blurry vision could see me straighter in the shape of the void in your family photograph next to your mother. Gyrating to constant hip-hop beats no one else could hear, your every strut was an MIC statement. Important and impulsive, uncontested, you insisted I comb the wild out of my hair as it threatened the royalty of your unkept mane. I humbly obeyed, because your body was sculpted by the gods, not Greek but Hindu. You had Ganesha's large one pack and Shiva's thighs. A holy excuse to down another 6-pack of Tiger, because your belly was the sign of prosperity, container of the universe. You wanted me to pray to, I became an atheist. But I still held your hand, added 2 more Tamil songs into my iPod playlist, speaking less British with more la in it. I even learned your mother tongue, but you always wanted us to go French, and I always had a sore throat. Then the astrology reading came back. Whether the bird picked the wrong tarot card or the Guruji was misconstrued, we were star-crossed. Destiny was a predetermined government policy, guaranteed with privileges, just not on our side. Our love was the last chapati you tore into pieces. Dipped in watered-down curry of reasons our ancestors forbade us to question, as they were unable to explain. I took one last look at you, knowing there would be no one else to share my biryani, but there are 8.9% of Indians in this country, a few doctors and plenty of DJs. Some as bald as Dataran Merdeka, some hairier than Taman Negara. But every now and again, I will think of you fondly, say a prayer in your name while climbing 272 steps up Batu Caves to the peak of our rapturous affair. Throw a stone and hope to God it hits the head of another matcha just like you. I can do the poetry part. The talking bits in between are the tricky ones. What am I saying? Okay. This festival reminds me how far I've come in terms of poetry. And it's because of people like Danny, I am here. I am constantly here. So you owe him. Like, put your hands together for Danny. And he is going to be launching my book, because there's no one else better in Penang to do it. And he's going to talk about it later, about why I wrote this book and why do I keep writing about Indian people, because no one else is doing it. Yes, so we're gonna talk about that. And that's at 5 p.m. at 216 at Beach Street. And you can also get it here at the back. That's one thing you can do. This is a poem that's very close to my heart. And I come from Selangor, and this is the Selangor state anthem. I will let the poem do its work. Duli Yang Maha Mulia Selamat di atas takhta. Lanjutkan usia tuanku, rakyat mohon restu, bawa duli tuanku. Blank was what they told me to fill in instead of the A word, or Tuhan, or God, or Jesus, or Buddha, or Brahma, Vishnu, Shiva, Lakshmi, or Saraswati. We'll figure it out eventually, but for now, it's blank. That they told me, the little girl in the navy blue pinafore, to say every time she stood up straight and sang with all her heart, remember, when we get to that part, you say blank.
which is be silent and then finish the rest. Maybe that's why she never became a singer. Instead, she was a poet who still struggled to memorize words that were for her to recite and not realize deeper meanings and understand why she had to spoil the rhythm of the song because they decided what was right from wrong, but never told her what to say when someone asked, "How come you never say blank?" As a sheet of paper, she wrote down her name, age, and classification of which blank she preferred to bow her head to. She was I, and I wondered if blank existed and what blank looked like. Did blank wear long dresses or a suit and tie? Or did blank speak English, Tamil, Chinese, or Malay? Or was blank here to stay during sunny days and stormy weather? I was never sure. If blank could spot me out of the 7 billion people or hear my voice against the whines and whimpers of believers asking their wishes to be granted. But is their blank different from my blank? Or are we all just blank trying to fill in the blank? We keep quiet to all that we do not understand, comprehend the fragments of experience through open eye meditation and the sound of silence resonating. As I put my palms together in front of colorful deities for 10 years, but saying, "Our Father, who art in heaven," when I know deep down that the only attention I was vying for was from my father who was upstairs taking a shower, who educated me and explained that Islam is a profound religion whose worshippers need no location of worship to worship, just a direction, and cautioned me never to trample on hungry ghost offerings on sidewalks, taught me that Christmas is more important than Santa Claus, and if we lit candles by the altar, we would be blessed, and that every temple is a GPS, an antenna, to give us better reception to the higher power, which I still refer to as blank. And I believed every threat of, "If you cross this line, then prepare to meet your maker." But what will I tell my children if they were made out of love from one man's blank and another woman's blank, not knowing which blank they really belong to? Because blank is not a word. Blank is not a state of mind. Blank is what we're still waiting to define, the divine. But I don't know when, and I don't know how. Till then, I am blank. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, Melissa Rani, give her a big hand. Come on. Her new book, Taboo, is out. You can get it at the Gerak Budaya book front, right at the back there. We're also going to be talking about Taboo later today at 5 p.m. at 216 Bookstore, which is like right across there and a bit to the right. You'll also find a lot of other books, but come, you know, come talk to Melissa, ask her questions, find out what the book is about, you know, how did she write it, what did she go through. So that's at 5 o'clock. Also, a big thank you to Melissa for, you know, saying some very nice things about us. Say It Like You Mean It is not just me, it's a group of really, really dedicated, really, really passionate people. Mark Walker is one of them. Shannon used to help us out a lot. Peter, Laika, Claudia, everybody pitches in just to give other people opportunities to shine. So could you please put your hands together for them for putting together this show today? Thank you. Thank you so much. After 3 years, we in the next 3 years, we're really hoping to give opportunities to a lot more Malaysian performers to make to do workshops in Penang, to do work, to take them to KL, to bring performers here, to do performances in Penang, about Malaysia. So the book that we've published is one way that we're raising funds to do that. So if you feel that, well, this is a pretty cool thing, do buy our book for 10 ringgit so that we can do more cool things. All right? Our next performer is a young woman who is she's signaling me some things at the back. Ah, okay. We'll get you the thing. But let me introduce you first, okay? Our next performer is a young woman who's just joined us a few months ago, but in that few short months, she's pretty much like blown everybody away with her writing. Her work is really intense, very powerful, and I'm very, very proud to present to you today Laika Jumaboy. Please put your hands together.
I think so. Oh, hello. Hi, everyone. So I'm also part of Say It Like You Mean It. And I'll be reading three pieces today. Two of the pieces are from the anthology Apung, which is wonderful, and you should go buy it. It's at the back. And one is... Okay, so I'm just going to get straight into it. The first piece is called Resilience, and it comes from experiences of my own life and also from my work as a counselor, and I hope that the piece speaks for itself. Our feet are chafing, our backs are breaking. We already missed a beat. Mistakes we are making, lub-dub we are forsaking. The nymphs shriek, fearing defeat. The sentinels of the old town clamor. She's been hit! She's been hit! They swing through the chambers, torches lit. Wary and watchful, they examine the gore. Severe damage to the left chamber and the right saw. No damage to the sack, but we'll need the kit. She grits her teeth, quivering in proud pain as the rhythmic restoration begins again. With clanging and creaking, paintings are reframed, shards swept up, and leaking walls plastered to the same. Old friends, anguish and betrayal flow through her canals, eager to play the game, maim or tame. She holds her head high, for she needed a year to recover the fifth time and 6 months to beat again after the fourth. She knows they'll say, she reaps what she sows. She knows they'll whisper, she gets worse as time flows. She holds her head high, for this old town knows, no matter what comes, no matter how it may go, she has to try, she has to hope. This old town holds her head high, for no matter what comes, no matter how it goes, she knows it's either try or dry up and die. Thank you. Okay. The second one, it's not in the anthology, so just have a listen. You cruise on the stubborn bird song of my love, a hypnotic chatter deafening me to should-dos, drowning out reproof from logic and reason of how, towards my love, you committed treason, of how your new leaves are as temporary as seasons. Limping, my love's chorus sounds still. When you coo forgiveness after threatening to kill, when you say, without me a life you cannot imagine, after you stuck your talons into my stomach just for running to the shop without your permission. You cruise on the coy cooing of my guilty shame that tells me I have only myself to blame for my forever choice of taking your name. Of how, if I listened better, or if I was obedient, if I didn't provoke you so, and was subservient, perhaps my arms wouldn't have these blue-black lumps. Perhaps my ears wouldn't hear the derogatory slurs that project from your mouth like clumps. Perhaps if I was better at sucking your cock, you wouldn't, with another, my vagina mock. You cruise on my gooey hope and fear, familiar accomplices in love's feral flock, the chirp of the possibility of you repenting and changing, if I am patient and keep praying, that squawk of bills to pay and mouths to feed, of how I have never stood to face the world alone, of how, if I tear myself from you, I am incomplete. Of unkind voices that will snigger, I wasn't good enough to keep you, so you had to spread your seed. While you are sleeping, hands cupped, I sit silently and ask. I ask that my love song be soon strangled, that bloodied and mangled, pulling itself by its wings, it leaves you, and in leaving you, frees me. Thank you.
Okay, this is the last one. It's called On Display. Their heads rotate round like revolving doors. Necks crane forward till they're all but sore. Eyes strain to leap free from their sockets. Their legs turn to trunks of trees, yoked to the ground by cruel curiosity, who deems this a view worthy of commentary. And their mouths, forgetting their manners, let loose at the sight of her limbs that ambulate forward with might in a cacophonic symphony of jerks and struts, while the snaking red welt that put itself into her right leg jigs in delight. Unabashedly, lips exclaim, "What's wrong with you?" Mind you, without so much as a "how do you do?" She longs to fire, "Nothing, dear onlooker, but may I ask, where have your manners gone to?" Those with self-contained, sickly, sympathetic curiosity croon to one another, "Poor dear, so pretty, what a pity." Still others, with pious curiosity, sinfully cry, "God will cure you, I'll pray for you, you must try." At times, she longs to say, "Dear onlooker, I do not bite. Your gawking and sympathetic gushing gleans you no insight. If you must ask, conduct a conversation before you leap. And if you dare not, do think to keep your precious comments away from me. For I doubt very much that you would like to be made to feel like a curious creature on display for all to see." She wants to rage at remarks so callously made, "Would you like a picture so you can look at it all day?" But no good comes of shouting, though appease her it may. She fights the crescendo of self-doubt that comes and goes as the searing stares make her feel alien from her hips to her toes. "My dear onlooker," she longs to say, "what does it feel like to be under a microscope?" "Well, I can tell you, it's not a pleasant feeling. No, I may move differently to those you see on an average day, but I'm not a spectator sport in any way." Thank you.
Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen, Laika. Her first poem published is in Apong, so if you want to check out the poems that she performed again, check out the chapbook that we have in the back, Apong. So we've tried to give you some very diverse forms and languages of poetry, some very different styles as well, from rap to page poetry to spoken word poetry. Now there's one more thing that we want to show to you. It is, for some of you, it may be something familiar. For the rest of you, it might be something completely new. I would like to introduce two people who have been with Say Like a Minute for a very long time and contributed so much. The first is a young woman named Shannon Francis, who writes as Hanno Frank. She's going to be performing poetry from her new book, Ecstatic, which is available right there in the back. But she's going to be doing it a little bit differently. with a songwriter and performer whose name is Z Ng. He's got his EP. I'm just saying, yeah. He joined us, you joined us when you were 17 years old.
14.
You joined us when you were 14 years old. And then he started with his first song, performed, I think the first time, I'd say like you mean not second time, something like that. And now he's got an EP out and he's performing all over the place and getting a lot of attention. So check it out. It's called The Midnight Sessions. So what we decided to do is put these two people together. Shannon will be doing poetry and Z will be interpreting it musically, the musical interpretation of Shannon's poetry. So I would like you to put your hands together for the last performance for today, Shannon and Z.
Hello, everybody. Z needs a minute to get his stuff together.
So hi, everyone. I'm Z. So I just wanted to say a bit about my work in musical interpretation. Now, I haven't done this a lot. My main work is in, as you've already heard, in songwriting, like rock, blues, basics, like, you know, your run-of-the-mill songs with choruses and verses. So I'd just like to say a few words about my experience doing this. Now, poetry, to a certain extent, is very different from music, though you might say it's similar due to the lyrical content and the way the words are still used and the way they impact the audience. But you have to remember that this is going to be really interesting. It was really interesting for me working on it, because poetry, unlike music, does not move in circles. You know, you have, you take any pop song, you know, maybe now we got bad blood, and then it goes back and over and over and over again. So, but poetry is a bit like classical music, which is why some people hate it and some people love it. But we like to say that it's finer. So it works in a line. So interpreting this has been a really interesting experience for me, and I hope you guys enjoy what we're doing here.
I cannot dissect the murky depths from the playful waves sparkling above. So it is with me. I offer you a moon intact with all phases, a fruit comprising sweetness and rot. But before I offer you these empty hands that hold creation and destruction, let me first fill them with flowers. I pray for the day that I can offer you my completeness, vibrating with the resonance of totality. bursting for joy that cannot be hidden or denied. Where comes this lightness and awareness of beauty in small, small things that I did not earn or expect? A tiny bird of negligible weight bears with ease enormous delight as if intending to share it with me. If I were to dare to hope, I would keep the truth alive in my heart, untouched by past or future.
Thank you.
I await for the moment that longing dissolves and the distance between us becomes filled with joy.
Thank you, Shannon and Z. That was amazing. I enjoyed it so much. So good. So exciting. You can get Shannon's book, Ecstatic, in the back at the Gorakh Budaya bookstore. You can get Z's EP, Midnight Sessions, there as well. This has been the Penang Showcase, hosted by Say It Like You Mean It, in collaboration with the Georgetown Literary Festival. We'd like to give them a big thank you. Thank you so much to all the performers who came and performed. Thank you so much to you for supporting us. Give yourselves a big hand, please, 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 please. If you'd like to follow us, find out what we're doing next, find out when the next show is, find us on sayitmeanitpenang.com. You can also find us on Facebook, sayitmeanitpenang. And if you want to help support us, please buy the Apong Crispy Poetry Anthology in the back. Thank you so much. You guys have been wonderful. That's it for the Penang Showcase. Thank you.